guys, good evening. So we have already done half of the CAT 2008 DI paper in the morning. We've already also discussed why we are doing CAT papers. We'll now just continue with DI. But before that, a quick introduction. Hi, I'm Munira Lokhandwala and I'm Calcutta alumna, a serial 100 percentiler in CAT and a 99 percentiler in GMAT. I also have a CAT verbal book published by Wiley and available on Amazon. Besides the Unacademy YouTube live channels, you can also find me on the Unacademy app. So, jaldi se, go to the Play Store, search for it, install it. Within that, you need to go for the plus CAT courses, right? I keep reminding you all, we have just started a very good test series that's free for subscribers. So, please go ahead and subscribe. With subscription to go for, we can talk towards the end of the session. You can use my code MUNIRA10 to get a 10% discount. So as usual, guys, we'll start off with a puzzle that I gave you all in the morning. You have a 3x3 table. The sum of the first two numbers equals the third number. Right? So this is your 3x3 table. Excuse the geometry. Okay, so this is a 3x3 table. The sum of the first two numbers equals in each row. So this is, you know, A, this is B, this is A plus B, right? And this is C, this is D, this is C plus D. And the column also, this is A plus C, this is B plus D, right? And this is true for each of the rows, so it's even true for the third row. So your third row is basically A plus B plus C plus D. Last cell, right? Now this cell we know is 15, and I want to find the sum of all the elements, right? Sum of the 9 numbers. So first of all, the sum of these 4 numbers is also, right, these 4, 1, 2, 3 and 4, ye bhi 15 hoga. Sum of these 2 numbers, this is also A plus B plus C plus D. See, we know A plus B plus C plus D is 15 because this is given to us. Okay, bottom right wala number 15 hai, right? And bottom right is the sum of this and it's also the sum of this and it adds up. So, ye 15 hai, matlab ye 4 ka sum bhi 15 hoga. These two will also add up to 15. So, that's another 15. And this is your third 15, correct? So, I'll just put the numbers, first 15. This is your second 15. And this is your third 15. And then you add up the last cell also, you add this up as well. So this is your fourth 15. Hence the sum of all the 9 numbers, guys, will be 60. That's your answer. Right? Great. So let's continue with the DILR set. You have a sports event where 6 teams are competing against each other. Matches are scheduled in 2 stages. First stage, 3 matches are played, and second stage, 2 matches are played. No team plays against the same team more than once in the event. So, abhi 6 teams hai. So, every team, right, has to play against 5 teams. And the way they play it is 3 in stage 1 and 2 in stage 2. There is no repetition, which means that they play with every other team exactly once. Matlab, A will have a match with B, A will have a match with C, with D, with E and F. Wo stage 1 mein hoga, stage 2 mein hoga, that we will find out. Okay. No ties are permitted, so somebody wins or somebody loses, and these observations are there. One team won, one da 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 da. So instead of me drawing an untidy table like we just did in the puzzle, I have made 2 tables already. Okay. So let's start putting in values. Right. So A will not play against A. Ye hum blank kar dete hain. Right? Okay. Now, one team won, the other team, 2 teams lost all matches. B lost to A, but won against C and F. Okay. So, we'll just write the team names, the winning team ka name. Right? So, D lost to A, that means A won, between A and D, right? A won, but won against C and F. So, yahan pe D won, against C and against F. D1, right? So even in this column, fill the row, fill the column so that there's no confusion, right? So D, and this is also D. So this information we have taken care of. E lost to B, but won against C and F. So E has lost to B, correct? So between E and B, B won. But against C and F, E is winning. So let's fill up the E column also, right? Okay, between E and B, B won. And then this is E, and this is also E. Let me just rub that off so that there's no confusion. Guys, carry an eraser for your exam, right? Instead of redrawing, it's just better to rub things off. Okay. So we've taken care of this. B lost at least one match. And F did not play against the top. So first of all, guys, wo kaun hai jo tino match jeeta hai, right? Which is the team which won all the three matches? So out of A, B, C, D, E, and F, right? C and F have lost against somebody or the other. So ye nahi ho sakta, right? Between the match of A and D, D has lost. A has won. So D bhi nahi ho sakta. B lost at least one match. So B bhi nahi ho sakta. Between E and B, B won. So E bhi nahi ho sakta. Guys, it is A. Okay. So now A has won all matches. This is the guy who has won all three matches. Okay. Now let's just complete the table. This is not possible. Correct? This is also not possible. Ye bhi apna bhar, you know, we can fill up D and E completely. Then we have two teams lost all the matches. Which are those two teams, guys, who would have lost all the matches? A, we know, is winning. B has won a match, right? D has won a match. E has won a match. Only C and F, they have lost all matches. And A has won. Okay. We know F did not play against. So, ye to not possible hai. Right, this is not possible, which means that the three teams A played with in the first stage can't be E, can't be F, it has to be B, C and D, and A is winning here. Ab C ke bhi teen match ho gaye, to ye bhi cut kar do. Right, ab you look at the B column, this is left. Correct? Two matches, B is not playing against C, B is not playing against D, B has to play with F, and we know F loses, so B wins. So, ye F ka bhi ho gaya, khatam, right? B wins. Now, this is left, guys, this cannot, right? We know C ke tino ho gaya hai, B ke bhi tino ho gaya hai, so this is a blank. So, we have filled in all the three matches and all the results also for the first stage. Now we have to look at the second stage. So, if you see, guys, the questions are with respect to stages. Like, first question is about stage 1 and stage 2, right? Then you have stage 2 questions. You have an overall question and with the most wins. So, what we'll do is, we will just do stage 2 in the second table. We'll not do a cumulative thing, correct? So let me just mark out the so let me just mark out you know, already stage 1 mein jo ho chuka hai, to ye possible nahi hai, ye possible nahi hai, correct? So A is only playing now A with E and F in stage 2. Similarly, B is playing with, so yahan pe bhi we'll just mark, right? E and F. B is playing with C and D. We are just saying that these two games are left. No, guys. B has to play with all five, out of which three is done, two is left. So this is what B will be playing here. Right? So B is playing against C and D. Then C is playing against B and F. Correct? D is playing against B. So wo to already ho chuka hoga, right? With So D is playing against B with and E. So B and E. B ka we have already filled up. सो दिस इज लेफ्ट एंड ई का भी दोनों गेम हो गया, एफ का भी दोनों गेम हो गया. सो वी हैव गॉट कि ये हमें भरना है अभी. ओके, द लीडर ऑफ स्टेज वन लॉस्ट द नेक्स्ट टू मैचेस. सो हु इज द लीडर ऑफ स्टेज वन? इट इज ए. ए लॉस्ट द नेक्स्ट टू मैचेस, विच मीन्स यहां पे ई एंड एफ वन. ई एंड एफ, हियर ऑल्सो ई एंड एफ. ऑफ द टू टीम्स एट द बॉटम आफ्टर स्टेज वन, वन टीम वन बोथ मैचेस. अभी बॉटम में कौन थे स्टेज वन पे? सी एंड एफ, राइट? ये दोनों ने, दे हैड लॉस्ट ऑल मैचेस. सी हैड लॉस्ट, एफ ऑल्सो हैड लॉस्ट. वन टीम वन बोथ, द अदर लॉस्ट बोथ. तो अभी सी और एफ में से आई कैन ऑलरेडी सी एफ हैज वन वन ऑफ द मैचेस. सो एफ कैनॉट लूज बोथ द मैचेस. एफ हेंस हैज टू विन बोथ द मैचेस. सो एफ एंड सी में एफ विन्स, राइट? एंड हियर ऑल्सो वी कैन से दैट F wins. So C guys is losing both the matches. So यहाँ पे B wins, correct? And here also we will put B. So F, so this also we have taken care of, that F winning both the matches and C losing both the matches. One more team lost both matches in stage two. Now it A to we have taken care of. B has already won a game. C we have taken care of, right? E is already winning one game. So D has lost both the matches. So यहाँ पे B आ गया है और यहाँ पे आ गया है E. So here also guys, you will have B, right? And you will have E. Great. So we have now, you can complete the table together. We have all the five matches. And now we can start looking at questions. The two teams that defeated the leader of stage 1 are, the leader of stage 1 was A. A played in the next stage with E and F and he was defeated by E and F, right? Second option. Next question, we'll have to keep coming back to this slide, right? The only team that won both matches in stage 2 are, so both matches in stage 2 guys, you have B here. B is winning both the matches, right? E is winning both the matches and F is also winning both the matches. You can just see row wise, right? You don't need to double check. It's B winning because you can see B and B. It is E winning, it is F winning, right? So for the next, your answer is going to be B, E and F, fourth option, right? Third question. The teams that won exactly two matches in the event are, so the team that won exactly two matches, we'll have to go back and check, right? So A has won three, lost two. B has won two and totally four B has won, right? You have to combine both the tables, guys. Yahan pe do B ne jeeta hai, B has won two here. C, we can see, has lost all. D, you have two matches, one year and zero year. So D has won two matches. And when you come to E, even E has won four. So not, you know, two year and two year. So both D has won two matches, B has won in stage one and F has won two matches, F has won it in stage two, right? So D and F is your answer, which is the fifth option, right? Final, the team with the most wins in the event are, so most wins, A is at three, B is at four, do yahan pe, correct? Then you have C with 0, you have D with 2 and you have E with 4. So both B and D, B and E have won 4 matches each, right? So that is your answer, fifth option, B and D. Great. So this set is not so bad and football sets have come a lot in the CAT. This is 1 year. Then they also had a football set in 2004, I think. And then there were football sets in 2013 as well. So, you see, that's why we do CAT questions, that we get used to the kind of sets that can come in, right? So now let's move on to the next set. The next set is not a lot of solving. For guys who are just watching this, the PDF of this whole slides, it's there in the description. So, you know, you should look at the PDF, solve it, and then watch the video solutions. Please, you know, doing the video solutions straight away is not a good idea. Unless you solve it, you will not really know the kind of mistakes also that you make, or better approaches also, because you will just know one approach, right? You need to have 2-3 approaches to a question. Okay. So, first question. First of all, what is the bar chart? The bar chart shows the revenue received in USD. It's a revenue from subscribers to a particular internet service. The data covers from 2003 to 2007. This, guys, is actual data and estimated from 2008 to 2010. Okay. So, yahan tak actual hai aur yahan se there is estimated. And this is revenue US or Europe ka across these many years. The difference between the estimated subscription in Europe in 2008 and what it would have been if it were computed using percentage growth rate of 2007 is closest to. So, pehle hame 2007 over 2006 ka percentage growth rate nikalna hai. This is Europe. Europe means we are looking at the black bar chart. Correct? So, 2007 over 6. 6 mein uska revenue hai. Around 380, 2007 mein revenue hai 500, so that is a change of 120 on 380, which is a little more than 30%. So the change from 06 to 07 is a 30% growth rate. If I apply that same change from 07 to 08, that means 500 would become 500 into 1.3, which is 650. So as of right now, your 2008 number is at 600. 600 or 650 mein you want to find the difference, right? The difference between actual, sorry, estimated and the percentage growth rate wala difference. So that is 50, right? Next question. In 2003, 60% of subscribers in Europe were men, okay? 60 were men, and how many then would be women? Automatically you can say 40 are women, correct? You have 60 men and 40 women. Men are growing at the rate of 5% and women are growing at the rate of 10%, correct? What is the approximate percentage growth of subscribers between 2003 and 2010? So, first you have to realize this, is this bar chart giving me number of subscribers? No, it is not. It is giving me the revenue. It is not telling me how many subscribers. Because it is not giving me subscribers, subscribers into subscription prices will give me this revenue, and that's what this statement is saying. Ke aap revenue ka chinta mat kijiye. Subscription prices are volatile. So whatever numbers you get, the revenue will take care of it. So basically, you know what? This is an independent question. Ye bar chart ke saath kuch lena dena hi nahi hai iska. Right? It's basically a maths percentages questions, compound interest question. Okay, so you start with 60 men. How are they growing? They are growing at 5%. How many years are they going to grow? From 03 to 10, that's 7 years. So this is one value that you'll need to find out. The other value is 40, right? Percent women. They are growing at the rate of 10%. So 7 years later, this is what they are going to be. So you could use a calculator here. Calculator may be actually, you know, multiplying 1.05 7 times is going to take some time. So you may want to actually find out if isko ek bar karoge, so it is, you know, square. So isko 1.05 square is this much. Isko cube karo and then multiply it with 1.05. So you'll get the value into 60, right? So this comes to around 84. And this also I would say ke same karo, you just do 40 into 1.21, right? Isko cube karo and then multiply it with 1.1. Or actually 1.1 ka to hume cube bhi pata hai na. So why can't we do this into 1.331? So multiply na, calculator kam use hota hai, time kam use hota hai. Correct? What we already know, we should straight away start applying. Theek hai? To ye ho gaya, this works out to around 78. So you start with 100, correct? 100 people, 60 men, 40 women, and you end up with 162. So you have a percentage growth of around 62. Right? You could actually do a little bit, if you don't want to use a calculator, what if, you know, this is an XAT question? How will you solve it? So you say, okay, if men are growing at the rate of 5% and women are growing at the rate of 10% and the ratio of mixing is 3:2, right? So the answer is going to be closer towards men. It is going to be 7%, right? I don't know how comfortable you are with mixing, but the way I would mix it is you're mixing 5 with 10. 5 ka ratio 3 hai, 10 ka ratio 2 hai. Point will be in the ratio 2:3. So your distance hai 5 ka, this you need to break up by putting 2 here, 3 here. So ye 7 aa jayega. So 7 for 7 years, guys, is close to 49%. Aur ye to just simple interest ho gaya na 7% ka. Correct? You will also have to apply compound interest. So the answer will be more than 50, it will be 62. That's a, you know, an approximate of doing it without using a calculator. Great, let's look at the third question. Consider the annual percent gap between US and Europe. What is the year in which the percentage difference, right, between 2 years is the highest? Absolute value of this change. So, aapko 2 saal ka percent nikalna hai, correct, of gap. So, for example, 2000, let's look at how do you solve it, right? 2003 mein the gap is 300, right? In 2004, the gap is going to be between subscription revenues, right? So, the gap is going to be close to but more than 320. So, here there's not a lot of change. Absolute wise also and even percentage wise also, right? You have a change of 320 on 300, right? That's a very small change. So where will you get more change? You will get max change where the gap really greatly increases or greatly reduces, correct? So yahan pe aap dekh rahe ho gap same hai, yahan pe bhi 300 ka hai, yahan pe bhi 300 ka hai, correct? Yahan the gap is close to 250, 200. This is where the gap becomes close to half. If close to 200 becomes close to 100. So this is the year where the gap will change. And if you find this out, right? Correct? So this gap of 190 becoming a gap of 90. Right? So 280 over 90 are difference here. So you will get the maximum absolute change between 2008 and 2009. Right? Great. Let's look at the next question. Fourth, while the subscription in Europe has been growing steadily towards that of the US, the growth rate in Europe seems to be declining. Which of the following is closest to the percent change in growth rate of 2007 over 2006 relative to the growth rate in 2000? Pehle hume do number nikale, correct? Ke 2007 or 2006 mein kya growth rate hai? And this is subscription in Europe. Everything is about Europe. So we are not concerned with US numbers. Okay. And then similarly, 2005 or 2004 mein kya growth hai? Aur phir ye dono ka percentage nikalna. Okay. So let's find out these two numbers first. 2007 over 2006. Okay. So 7 over 6 we have already found out. It's close to, but a little more than, right? So you get 120 on 380. That is a little more than 30%, right? Around 31%. This is 2007 over 2006. Now 2005 over 2004 means we are looking at these two numbers. You have 180, around 180, yeah. Or 190, let's say, and this is 280. So that's a change of around 90 on 190. Correct? Which is a 47% growth rate. Right? This 90 ka increase over 190 is 47. Now if I take the closest percent change, right? So 31% over 47%. This gap that I take, right? This is close to 66. It's 2/3, 66%. So the change is around 35, right? The change from 1 minus 66, you'll find out as a percentage, that is 35%. Right? Great. Let's look at the next set. A, B, and C are three professional traders who trade in shares of a company XYZ Limited. Abdul follows the strategy of buying at the opening and selling the whole lot at the close of the day, right? So he buys at 10 and he closes at 3. Bikram follows the strategy of buying at hourly intervals. So he buys at 10, 11, 12, 1, etc. And he sells everything at 3 p.m., right? At the end of the day. Whereas Chetan also does the same thing. But this guy buys equal number of shares and this guy buys equal amount, equal investment karta hai. So anyways, here only you should be aware ke agar I buy 2 shares at 20 rupees and 2 shares at 30 rupees. So this is not something that you know you need here so much, but it's just something that you should know, correct? Okay, when the number of shares are equal, this is like time speed distance, then the average share price, correct? You have bought 40 plus 60 mein 4 shares, right? 40 yahan pe, 60 yahan pe. Average share price is 25, which is the arithmetic mean. So for Bikram, you will have arithmetic mean as the average of his share price. Chetan, who's investing the same amount. So if he's investing the same amount, you will take a multiple of 20 and 30. Let that be 60 rupees. So he's investing 60 rupees at the first time, correct here. So he's buying 3 shares and here he's buying 2 shares. So totally at 120 rupees, he's buying 5 shares. So his average price per share, guys, is 120 divided by 5, 24. This is a harmonic mean. So Chetan ka average price will be harmonic mean. Ye ek question mein kaam bhi aayega hume, right? And the most important thing is harmonic mean is less than the arithmetic mean of positive numbers. Correct? Okay. So now let's look at the questions. On a day of fluctuating market prices, the share price of XYZ ends with a gain. That is higher at the close of the day compared to the opening value. Which trader got the maximum return on that day? So obviously it can be Abdul. Correct? Positive return to Abdul ko mila hai. Right? Bikram, we don't know what is the share price. You know the share price. Ye opening day share price hai. Ye closing hai. So this is closing is more than opening. If it is going like this, maybe these other guys faced a loss. But if it is going like this, then it was cheaper somewhere later. And Bikram and Chetan may have made more money. Right? So you cannot determine right now. Between Bikram and Chetan also, you cannot determine. Because you don't know when it is lowest. Okay? If you knew when it was lowest, how it is increasing or decreasing, then you could have still answered. But as it is, you cannot determine. You just know that the opening is less than the closing. Beech mein kya ho raha hai? No idea. Next question. Which one of the following statements is always true? Abdul will not be one. So now here guys, hume pata hai ke Bikram, okay, is buying equal number of shares. So uska average buying price, his average buying price will be the arithmetic mean of all the numbers, right? All these are positive numbers. जो भी है ए बी सी डी ऑल नंबर्स इसका अरिथमेटिक मीन होगा बिक्रम करेक्ट का एवरेज बाइंग प्राइस फॉर चेतन द एवरेज बाइंग प्राइस विल बी द हार्मोनिक मीन ऑफ दीज नंबर्स एंड वी नो दैट द हार्मोनिक मीन इज लेस देन और इक्वल टू the arithmetic mean. So it's important to remember, if all the numbers are equal, if the share price doesn't move at all, then Bikram and Chetan will make the same amount of return, right? But if it moves even a little bit, then Chetan will be higher than that of Bikram. So it's very tempting to mark option 2, but actually answer should be option 5. If this was that return for Bikram cannot be higher than that of Chetan, right? So Chetan is higher or equal to, Chetan is never less than Bikram. That we have to remember. Agar ye aisa option hota, to fourth would have been right. But as of right now, 2 ho sakta hai. If the share price even moves a little bit, Chetan will make a higher return than Bikram, correct? But if it stays constant, then Bikram will be equal to Chetan, will be equal to Abdul. So none of the above, right? Third question. On a boom day, the share price keeps rising throughout the day and peaks at the close of the day. Which trader got the minimum return of the day? So which trader got the maximum return? Abdul has bought at the cheapest price and so, right? The share price is moving up throughout the day. That's what it's a boom day, right? It's moving up throughout the day. After reading all this, I'm feeling like trading. So A, who's buying at the beginning at the cheapest price and selling at the end, right? At the highest price, is making maximum return per question puch raha hai minimum. Correct? So minimum ke liye, we are looking at Bikram or Chetan. So as we have already mentioned, guys, correct? There, Bikram is buying at all these times and selling together at 3 o'clock. Whereas Chetan is also doing the same thing, but Bikram is going to pay a higher price. His average buying price is higher than Chetan. So his return will be lower than Chetan. And here the answer is 1. So just that knowledge of arithmetic mean and harmonic mean, right? Time, speed, distance, wala knowledge. That if it is equal time, your average speed is arithmetic mean. If it is equal distances, then your average speed is the harmonic mean. It's the same concept here, right? Because I'll tell you why it's same also. See, distance is equal to speed into time. Investment is equal to number of shares into price. So if time is same, correct? Average speed is arithmetic mean. If number of shares are the same, average price is the arithmetic mean. If distance is the same, average speed is the harmonic mean. And if investment is the same, average buying price is the harmonic mean. Okay. So Bikram makes the minimum return because Bikram's arithmetic mean of the same numbers is more than Chetan's harmonic mean. So his average buying price is more. That means he makes less money. Okay. Now we'll look at 4 and 5. Usme extra information diya gaya hai. So out of all the data sets that we have done, guys, these questions really make it a little bit tedious. Okay, we have to slow down. So let's see what's given to us. One thing at a time, right? You have now two more people, D and E. They followed a strategy of buying equal number at 10, 11 and 12 and selling the same numbers at 1, 2 and 3. Okay, so Dane buys at 10, 11, 12. Emily, on the other hand, followed the strategy of buying shares using all her money at 10 and selling them at 12 and again buying the shares for all the money at 1 and again selling all of them at the close of the day at 3. Okay. So, Abdul lost money in the, what is Abdul doing, guys? Abdul is buying at 10 and selling at 5. And now we have to have an idea. If you see the question, right, we need to have an idea about share price. So let's say ke 10 baje ka share price, correct, is A rupees, correct. 11 baje ka is B. 12 baje ka C hai. 13 is, which is 1 o'clock, right, is D. 2 o'clock is E. And 3 o'clock is F. Okay. So Abdul lost money in the transaction, which means he bought at a higher price than he sold. So ye apna important hai yahan pe, because we are getting one relationship. Dane and Emily, they both made profits. Now, what is Dane doing? Dane is buying at 10, 11, 12, which means that his buying price is A, B plus C divided by 3, equal number hai, correct? And he is selling at 1, 2 and 3. So, she's made profit, right? So, the selling price of D plus E plus F is more than the cost price of A plus B plus C. Okay? This is second information. Now, यहाँ पे ही हम रुक जाते हैं एक सेकेंड के लिए. See, A is more than F. But if A plus B plus C is less, correct? तो ये A तो बहुत बड़ा है F से, पर B plus C डालने से छोटा हो जाता है. That means B plus C, guys, has to be less than D plus E. Then only this will be true. So what we have done is कि ये जो थोड़ा ज्यादा variables थे, अभी ये इतना important नहीं है. Using this, we have got this. Right? We have used this fact into this. Okay? Now Emily has also made money. How will Emily make money? Emily is buying, right? She is buying at 10 and she is buying at 1, which is D. And then she is selling at 12, which is C, and at 3, which is F. And she has made money, right? So the selling price is more than the cost price. So we yahan pe bhi ruk jate hain. See, we know A is greater than F. But if A plus D is less than C plus F, that means D is less than C. Okay, this is important. D is less than C. Now, if you come back here, we know that between C and D, C is greater. But phir bhi B plus C becomes less than D plus E. So that means B is less than E. Correct? We know C is greater than D. But B add karne se B plus C chota ho jata hai. So B must be smaller than E. So ye teen hume mil gaye hain. Okay? Then we have other things also. There was an increase in share price during the closing hour compared to the price at 2 p.m. 2 p.m. price is E. Right? So F is more than E. So isko yahan pe dal dete hain na. Correct? Closing hour is more than E. Share price at 12 noon was lower than the opening price. Okay, so C is less than A. Aur ye E B ka relationship bhi hum yahan pe dal sakte hain. So you have two threads. A is greater than F is greater than E is greater than B. And A is greater than C is greater than D. So where is the share price highest? It is highest in the morning at 10 a.m. A is the highest, right? Amongst all of these. So 4 is 10 a.m. Second, which of the following is necessarily false? Share price was at its lowest at 2. Low happens at B, right? Or it happens at D. B or D matlab 11 ya 1 baje lowest hota hai. So 1, guys, is necessarily false because 2 p.m. pe definitely lowest nahi hota hai, right? But actually ye question mein thoda error tha if you check other options. Share price was at its lowest at 11 a.m. This we know is true. It can be true. Not true. This can be true. If I want necessarily false, matlab it has to be false. Which means that if something that can be true is allowed. Right? Because 11 ka can be true. Share price at 1. Correct? So if you look at A, B, C, D, E and F. This 11, 12, 1, 2, 3. Right? So share price at 1. Was higher than the share price at 2. So D or E ke beech mein do we have a relationship, guys? D and E? No, they come. You have AFEB and ADCA. So we cannot come up with any relationship. So it may or may not be true. But do we have a relationship between D and C? We do, right? That C is greater than D, which means 12 o'clock price is higher than 1 o'clock price. So if, you know, 4 is also true. So, ye, I have told you in the past also that CAT questions mein mistakes hote hain, errors hote hain, guys. So, if you get something, don't get lost. Don't keep, you know, moving around in circles. Just move on to the next question. Finish everything else. Fir time bachta hai to aake jo error hai wo check karo. Abhi yahan pe if I start, so a lot of us will just get one, mark it and move on, which is great. That's not a problem. But if some of us are checking, right, and if you know, you don't get any option also. Aisa bhi ho sakta hai. Kabhi do option, kabhi zero option. That does not mean you are wrong. Move on to the next question. Come back to it later. Agar aap wapis shuru karoge question, there's a higher chance of cracking the error if you have made an error. If you just keep revolving around the question, revolving around what you have done and not starting afresh, you'll not trap the error that easily, right? So great, I hope you'll enjoy today's session. Your bonus puzzle. So in this diagram, each of the three identical circles touch the other two. The circumference of one circle is given. What is the perimeter of the shaded region? So you are looking at the perimeter, right? You are not looking at the area. It is very, so this is your, if I just draw the perimeter, guys, this is what you want. Okay, so do solve this. Here's your reading assignment. I hope you all are reading. I know it's very boring, but believe me, aisa kuch aapke cat mein aisa hi kuch aayega. Toh padhte raho. Please keep reading. Okay. Finally, we'll meet each other again tomorrow morning, right? When we'll do some more cat questions. And you can also see me on the Unacademy app. Please, guys, install the app, take the test. There are a lot of good features. First of all, it's one of the best environments for learning. So the whole setup, right? The whole program, it is very, very good for learning. And then you have all these live doubt solving sessions, etc. So you must subscribe. If you are focused on CAT 2020, then you can look at the 12-month subscription. If you're confused between 20 and 21, then you should go for the 24-month subscription, right? You can use the code MUNIRA10 to get a 10% discount. So guys, I hope you enjoyed the session and I hope